Let's use the 11 Labs API to make some music. We recently launched 11 Music, the first fully licensed music generation model. Now, let's see how we can use the API to integrate music into our applications. To help you get started, we created this V0 community starter template for you. So what you can do here is you can see an example application that will generate music and stream it from the server to the client side. So what we can do is we can open this in V0. As you can see, we will need to add our 11 Labs API key here. So in order to get an API key, we can simply go to 11labs.io. We can log in. If you don't have an account yet, you can create one. And here we have the developer portal where we can manage all our API keys. So what we can do is we can create a new key. We can also set specific restrictions here. For example, if we want to restrict it to a certain amount of credits, say 100,000 credits per month. So we can have some control here. And we can see in our case, we only want to generate music. So we'll give access for this API key for music generation. And then we can say V0 music streaming app, so that we know that this is what our key is used for. Now, do note that this is a secret key, so please keep this API key secret and make sure you only use it in secure server environments. So here in V0, we're adding these environment variables for usage on the server. So we can save that here. And now if we jump into the code, what we can see is that we here have an API route. And so in this API route, which is a secure server context, we can use our 11 Labs secret key. So here we're using the 11 Labs JS package, and we import the 11 Labs client, provide our API key, which is coming from the environment variable, so securely on the server side. And you can see here, to generate some music with the 11 Labs API is incredibly easy using that package. So you just call the 11 Labs client music, and in our case, we want to stream the music. So as soon as the generation starts returning a token, we want to start streaming the music to our client. So simply here, we provide the text prompt. We could, of course, put some rate limiting in here as well, or some user authentication if we want to make sure that, you know, only the authenticated user can actually hit this endpoint. So this we could all add here because we have a secure server route. And then here, the audio stream that is being returned is a readable stream. So what we can do is we can actually directly return that readable stream as a response here and return that to the front end as a stream. So now let's look at the client side of things. So on the client side, we are simply putting together our stream URL. So as you saw, this route here is a GET request. And so as we're hitting the API here, we're encoding our text prompt, and then we are adding our parameters, the duration and such, as these are options on the client side. And we're sending these to our server. And then if you remember, we're getting back a stream directly. And so we can use the web audio API to directly get that stream and play it back from the client side. So you can see here, we have a couple event listeners just on our audio stream. And then lastly, we have here, you know, just some UI components, some loading. All this was generated kindly by V0 for us. So here we can see we have the audio player. So once we have an audio URL, we can then see that we have the audio player here. And when the generation is done, you can see here just on the button click, we're then toggling the playback. And you can see here the toggle playback is just, again, using our audio reference. And, you know, it's just playing it back then. There we go. All right, let's give this a go. So we'll say we want a Cuban jazz jingle. Maybe the duration will just do 10 seconds for now, and then we hit generate music. So now we're going back to our API route. Our API route is calling the 11 Labs music API. And as soon as that generation is finished, we will start streaming it here. Here we go. And now you have custom music in your application that, you know, you can give to your users. The sky's the limit here. You can build some collaborative applications, maybe have people, you know, join in, generate their music, have a big, you know, infinite playlist. We're really excited to see what you will build with this. And do let us know on X what you're building. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks for tuning in and see you next time.